For over 90 years, Talyllyn and Dolgoch ran the railway between them. The arrival of the preservationists not only brought new locomotive power in the form of the Corus engines, but new ideas as well. Preparing a steam engine for work is a long and dirty task, one only matched by cleaning them down at the end of the day. By 1952, with locomotive power somewhat in hand, an engine which could be started quickly and handle light duties was sought. The solution arrived at was a petrol locomotive designed by David Kirwan, who had been the engineering expert who had kept Dolgoch going through her first season in preservation. The challenge of creating something from nothing was one with which Kirwan was uniquely familiar. The heart of the newly arrived Number 5 was a slate wagon chassis powered by the engine from Tom Rolt's defunct narrowboat Cressy. With no gearbox, the original Number 5 struggled with the lightest of loads. Whilst just about able to handle the weekly market train over the winter months of a carriage and the Corus van, it did so whilst pumping exhaust and oil into the air. Some crews preferred to sit on the sides instead of on the seat in the open cab. During its short life running on the Talyllyn, it earned the nickname of the Lawnmower. During Easter 1953, the old canal boat engine seized solid and couldn't be turned over. The bold experiment was put aside for another day, and the Number 5 was given to the Ruston Diesel Midlander, which proved more than capable of tackling the needs of the fledgling Preservation Society. As time went on, the Lawnmower became known as Rolt's Folly. But to many, it wasn't a folly. It was an important part of Talyllyn history, a part where people were doing the best with what they had to run a railway in a way which had never been done before. The petrol engine was converted into a flat wagon, and the flat wagon still exists. The Talyllyn has changed a great deal since the 1950s, but there are plans to rebuild Number 5, at least visually, using as authentic a selection of pieces as possible. Maybe, just maybe, Rolt's Folly will ride again. Number 5 was not the only experiment that the Talyllyn ran, however. The original Number 7 was also a departure from the norm. Arrived in 1954, this yard tractor had had its pneumatic tyres replaced by rail wheels and was powered by an elderly Ford engine that was soon adapted to run on paraffin. A canopy was added to add some meagre protection against the unpredictable Welsh weather. Number 7, nicknamed Charlie's Ant, was not successful at pulling trains, as its differential meant that it lost all traction if it slipped. The three-speed and reverse gearbox proved a challenge for an engine which spent half its life running backwards, and the engine had to be pushed to full throttle to achieve walking speed. Here, we see it on its innovative turntable, designed to avoid this problem. It was not perfect. Number 7 was constantly in trouble, and John Bates' motor trolley and Midlander quickly became the go-to choice for volunteers. By 1958, it was seldom used, and by 1959, it was defunct. Volunteers running a railway had never been done before the Talyllyn, and while most people involved had a deep interest in railways, few had the practical experience to go with it. The ideas behind the original Numbers 5 and 7 might seem eccentric to our modern eyes, but they were, in their own ways, pioneers that deserve to be recognised for their contribution to our railway heritage.